silence your phones and remind you that the taking of photographs and use of recording devices is strictly prohibited. Face coverings are encouraged while inside the Majestic Theater for the safety and comfort of those around you. The Phantom of the Opera Orchestra is conducted by David Cadden. Discovered in the vaults of the theater, still in working order, ladies and gentlemen.
Show in here.
May I commence at 20 francs? Oh, come, come, ladies and gentlemen, 15 then. 15, thank you. Yes, 20 from you, sir. Thank you very much.
25.
25 on my left. Thank you, madam. 25, I am bid. 30. Selling at 30 francs, then. 30 once, 30 twice. Sold for 30 francs to the Vicomte de Chagny. Thank you once again, sir.
Oi. Collector's piece, indeed. Every detail exactly as she said. She often spoke of you, my friend. Your velvet lining and your figurine of lead. Will you still play? When all the rest of us are dead.
Lot 666, then. A chandelier, until recently believed destroyed. Some of you may recall the strange affair of the Phantom of the Opera, a mystery never fully explained. We are told, ladies and gentlemen, that this is the very chandelier which figures in the famous disaster. Our workshops have restored it and fitted parts of it with wiring for the new electric light so that we may get a hint of how magnificent it will look when reassembled. Perhaps we may frighten away the ghost of so many years ago with a little illumination, gentlemen!
of Chalumeau's Hannibal. Ladies and gentlemen, some of you may already, perhaps, have met Monsieur André and Monsieur Firmin.
I'm sorry, Monsieur Lefebvre, we are rehearsing. If you wouldn't mind waiting a moment.
My apologies, Monsieur Ray. Proceed, proceed.
Thank you, Monsieur.
Monsieur Ray, our chief repetitor. Rather a tyrant, I'm afraid.
Sir, to return, Signor.
And to return to find the land we love, taken to its mobile lungs, our eating grass. Tomorrow we shall make the change of Rome. Good night, rejoice, your early has come.
Gentlemen, please, if you would kindly stand to one side.
My apologies, Madame Giry. Madame Giry, our ballet mistress. I don't mind confessing, Monsieur Firmin, I shan't be sorry to be rid of the whole blessed business.
I keep asking you, Monsieur, why exactly are you retiring?
We take a particular pride here in the excellence of our ballets.
What's the matter? You, Christine Daaé. Concentrate, girl.
Daaé, curious name.
Swedish.
Any relation to the violinist?
His daughter, I believe, always has her head in the clouds, I'm afraid. Giudicelli, our leading soprano for 5 seasons now.
Of course, I have experienced all your greatest roles, Signora.
Piacere.
And Signor Ubaldo Piangi.
An honor, Signor.
Piangi.
If I remember rightly, Elisa has a rather fine aria in Act 3 of Hannibal. I wonder, Signora, if as a personal favor, you would oblige us with a private rendition. Unless, of course, Monsieur A objects.
My man, at your commands, Monsieur Mayor.
My diva commands. Will Troubaz be sufficient introduction?
Quite sufficient.
Maestro.
Very well.
From the beginning of the aria, then. Mademoiselle.
makes you. Are you a dancer? Then come and practice. Rehearsals. Always rehearsals. My dear, I was asked to give you this. A red scarf. The attic. Little Lottie.
A tour de force. No other way to describe it.
What a relief. Not a single refund.
Greedy.
Richard, I think we've made quite a discovery in this Daaé.
Here we are, Monsieur le Vicomte.
Yes, gentlemen, if you wouldn't mind, this is one visit I should prefer to make unaccompanied to.
Oh, as you wish, monsieur.
Thank you.
They appear to have met before.
Christine Daaé, where is your red scarf?
Monsieur.
You can't have lost it. But after all the trouble I took, I was just 14, soaked to the skin.
Because you had run into the sea to fetch my scarf. Oh, Rouse, what is you?
Christine. Little Lottie, let her mind wander.
You remember that too.
Little Lottie thought, am I fonder of dolls or of goblins of shoes?
Or of riddles of frocks?
Picnics in the attic, or of chocolates?
Father playing the violin.
We read to each other dark stories of the north.
Oh, what I love best, Lottie said, is when I'm asleep in my bed and the angel of music sings songs in my head.
The angel of
music sings songs in my head. Father said, when I'm in heaven, child, I will send the angel of music to you. Well, Father is dead, brother. And I have been visited by the angel of music.
There's no doubt of that. But now we go to supper.
No, brother. Well, the angel of music is very strict.
I shall keep your blades.
No, brother.
You must change. I must get to my house. 2 minutes. Little Lottie.
Things have changed, Raoul.
Excellent boy, the slave of fashion, basking in your glory. Ignorant fool, this brave young seater, sharing in my triumph.
first heard you sing. I have needed you with me to save me, to sing for my music. My music.
Thank you. can turn to love, you learn to see, to find the man behind the monster that's repulsive carcass, who seems a beast, but secretly dreams of beauty, secretly.
Send it.
Of course not.
As if he would.
He didn't send it.
Of course not. What's going on?
You have to tell me.
Your taste, the opera popular are numbered. Christine Daaé will be singing on your behalf tonight. Be prepared for a great misfortune should you attempt to take her place.
Far too many notes for my taste, and most of them about Christine. All we've heard since we came is Miss Daaé's name.
I think our meeting is adjourned.
Where precisely is she now?
I thought it best that she went home.
She needed rest.
May I see her?
No, monsieur, she will see no one.
Will she see? No, will she see? No.
Here, I have a note.
Let me see it, please.
Gentlemen, I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature, detailing how my theatre is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you one last chance.
Christine Daaé has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress in the new production of Il Muto. You will therefore cast Carlotta as the patron, and put Miss Daaé in the role of Countess. The role which Miss Daaé plays calls for charm and appeal. The role of the page boy is silent, which makes my casting, in a word, ideal.
I shall watch the performance from my normal seat in box 5, which will be kept empty for me. Should these commands be ignored, a disaster beyond your imagination will occur.
I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G.
Christine!
What evidence
is all about Christine?
I know who sent these, the Vicomte to love us.
Indeed, can you believe this?
Senora!
Boy, the silent role. Carlotta will be playing the lead.
You don't deserve her.
It's useless for me to choose.
Deputies are on their knees to implore you. beyond imagination will occur!
Oh, he makes me laugh.
Behold, she is singing to bring down the chandelier!
Ladies and gentlemen! We apologize. The performance will continue in 10 minutes' time, when the role of the Countess will be sung by Miss Christine Daaé.
Raoul!
Don't worry, I'm with you.
In the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, we shall be giving you the ballet! The ballet from Act 3 of tonight's opera. Maestro, bring the ballet part. The ballet!
Thank you.
that.
Monsieur André.
Dear André, what a splendid party.
The prologue, your bright new year. Yeah. Toast of all the city.
Such a pity that the phantom can't be here.
Thank you. To comply, my instructions should be clear. Remember, there are worse things than a shattered chandelier. Your chains are still mine. You will sing for me.
Learn that their place is in an office.
relish not the arts. As for Miss Christine Daaé, no doubt she'll do her best, it's true. Her voice is good, she knows, though should she wish to excel, she has much skill to learn, if pride will let her return to me, her teacher.
I can't. I won't do it.
We have all been blind, and yet the answer is staring us in the face. This could be the chance to ensnare our clever friend.
Well, Esty,
we shall play his game. Perform his work, but remember we hold the ace. For if Miss Daaé sings, certain to attend.
We make certain the doors are barred.
We make certain all men are there. We make certain there aren't. The curtain falls. His reign will end.
Madness!
I'm not so sure.
Not if it works.
This is madness!
The tide will turn.
Monsieur, believe me, there is no way of turning the tide.
You stick to ballet.
They help us.
Monsieur, I call.
Instead of warning us.
Help us.
I wish I could.
I'll make excuses. How could it be that you're on his side?
She's his accomplice. Monsieur, believe me, I intend no ill. But Monsieur, be careful, we have seen him.
Take the fallen body will.
While he lives.
Signor Piangi. Here is the phrase. Those who tangle with Don Juan, if you please.
Those who tangle with Don
Juan. But no, those who tan.
Signora, would you speak that way in the presence of the composer?
The composer is not here.
And if you were
certain of that, Signora.
So, once again, if you please. Signor Piangi, after seven, five, six, seven!
You were
She dines with you in your master's violin face. Furtively whisker, flavor, stealing word and truth, he's my quality and modesty, starts to live with the wine.
I come home, I use your voice, slap the door, I crack off too.
I shall cry and hide with me, where the world goes my room.
Hasn't got a child.
Here's my hat, my cloak, and sword. Come with these assured him. I'll not forget myself and laugh.
A point of no return. No calling back now. A passion.
the dismal place. Not for any more tosses of the wickedness of my abhorrent face. Handed out by everyone, not with hatred everywhere. No kind word from anyone, no compassion anywhere. Christine, Christine, why? Why? Madam Giry, thank you.
Tears I might have shed.
not for Chagny, too late for Perez, he is this idiot. Astro, what a prize for
him. My life,
no point in fighting.
I love you.